2013 is a great year to see the Northern Lights, also known as the Aurora Borealis, because the sun's at the peak of an 11-year solar cycle. But what actually causes them? Well, it's actually our feisty sun. Inside the sun's core, nuclear fusion bakes hydrogen into helium at ridiculously hot temperatures. And even in the outer layer of the sun, known as the corona, temperatures can reach up to 1,000,000 degrees centigrade, making particles zip around at uber-fast speeds. And if these particles go over 400 kilometers per second, they can actually escape the sun's gravity and stream out across space in something known as the solar wind. Now, fortunately for us, we've got a protective mechanism against this solar wind, because otherwise all life on Earth would be completely fried by its lethal radiation. And this protective mechanism is the Earth's magnetic field. Deep inside the Earth's iron core, there's an intensely hot crystal centre that stirs up the molten iron around it, creating magnetic forces. And it's these magnetic forces that create like a sort of protective envelope around the Earth called the magnetosphere, which deflects most of the solar wind, but just occasionally charged particles manage to sneak through and spiral in at the poles, where they smash into the upper atmosphere. Now, to find out where the atmosphere finishes, check out James May's video by clicking here. And when these particles smash into the upper atmosphere, they collide with nitrogen and oxygen ions, absorbing their energy. And it's only when these ions relax back into their natural state that they radiate light. And the different colours that you see in the Northern Lights are actually due to the different types of nitrogen and oxygen ions. So nitrogen ions emit red, blue and purple light. Oxygen emits red and yellow. And when you see a green glow in the Northern Lights, it's actually a really nice mix of nitrogen and oxygen ions together. Now, aurorae can also be seen in southern latitudes. They're known as the Southern Lights or the Aurora Australis, because they can be seen down around Australasia, Antarctica and the southern tip of Latin America. And the best time to see them is between March and September. Aurorae are also found on other planets in our solar system. Jupiter and Saturn both have stronger magnetic fields than Earth. And the Hubble Space Telescope has actually captured images of aurorae on Uranus and Neptune. But back on Earth, for your best chance to see the Northern or Southern Lights, head as far north or as far south in terms of latitude and head out on a really crisp, clear night. And fingers crossed, you'll catch this amazing light show.